We continue to follow the investigation into a man accused of offering women rides, then beating and raping them. Action 7 News reporter Brian Martin is here with more on the Matthew Sagato case.
Yeah, Doug, police say Sagato was impersonating a police officer when he picked up those women. We wanted to know, just how easy is it to go to a police supply store and turn yourself into an officer? Turns out, it's not very easy at all. Police say a couple of weeks ago, Matthew Sagato offered a woman a ride, took her to an alley where he punched and raped her. The victim told police Sagato was wearing a shirt with the word police on it and had a law enforcement patch ironed on. 6 months ago, police say this man, Orlando Jaramillo, was also impersonating a police officer, decking out his car, showing off a badge, even carrying a firearm. At Neve's Uniforms and Equipment on San Mateo.
Do we still have a list of the bad checks?
Manager Mike Driggers remembers Orlando Jaramillo.
Orlando, two checks. Do not take checks from him. The critical part of a uniform is the patches that identify the department.
This is Mike's collection of patches from all across the state. Patches that he says only go to people with either identification or a purchase order.
Without either a PO from the city, from the county or state, then they're not allowed to purchase.
But what about T-shirts that say police or sheriff on them?
That's something that they can buy.
Really?
Yeah.
Somebody could just buy one of those?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
But try buying pretty much anything else, and Driggers says you better be who you say you are.
We ask for ID. And without ID, we can't sell that item to them.
Driggers admits there are some places, even online, where civilians can go to buy patches and badges, but he says Neve's won't be one of them. Doug, back to you.
Police tell us they have not had any more victims from the Sagato case come forward.